Welcome back to ANC Presents Chief Justice on Trial. We're still here in the Senate with Congressman Nery Colmenares of the prosecution and Attorney Rico Quicho of the defense, and in the studio, former Dean Raul Pangalangan of the UP College of Law and Dean Tony Lavinia of the Ateneo School of Government. Gentlemen in the studio, let me just ask you, let me just get your projections for the trial. How soon do you think this will be wrapped up, and how long a time do you think the senators will need to deliberate and to think it over?
If I follow the defense, and having been very, very disciplined from what I have observed, then they will be done before the recess, I think on the third week of March. I suppose they will, both camps will be then given, bibigyan sila ng deadlines to give a memorandums, because they have to tie the evidence that they have presented against each other to make the case. I wish that there will be a chance to actually do oral summaries. In the Clinton case, that was really the best part, because you're able, this is a policy, this is not a judicial trial, this is a policy debate. And so we need the argument on why or why not the Chief Justice should be convicted, and why or why not he should be censured or removed, right? So I suspect that if that's the case, then after the resumption, I think after 3 weeks, sometime in mid-April, or when Congress resumes, we might have another week or two. Then there'll be deliberation, and then they'll, So I think by the end of May or middle of May, we will be done. And by the first, the next asana of the president, this will be a thing of the past. Hopefully.
So you think the senators will need the break to think things over?
No? Well, not so much of that, but because there needs to be a memorandum, unless both parties say they're ready for the memorandum the next day or the week after, right? Mm-hmm. It's just that they would have to do their memorandums, and as I said, if I would really encourage final summaries on prime time, for all the Filipino people to watch. As the evidence is tied up and the argument for conviction and for removal, censure, or just pure acquittal is given.
So Dean Raul. But I'm sorry.
No longer than May, I think, where we're over with this.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, Linda, I'm hoping that it will, that the verdict will be in much earlier, maybe a month earlier, soon after Holy Week. But let me just explain what Tony referred to as the memorandum. It is really nothing but a summary of the proceedings, where the lawyer for one side will weave together the charges contained in the articles of impeachment, and then he will match that with the evidence that he was able to present and demonstrate to the court the facts that he was able to establish. So for me, the function of the memorandum is actually to help the judge, in this case, the senator judges, to piece together the entire trial in one neat bundle. Now, lawyers usually take about a month to do that. I'm hoping that, well, given the high-profile nature of this trial, that they have been putting together the memorandum as the evidence has come in, so that they wouldn't ask for 30 days within which to do that, and that they can, as soon as the defense rests, that they can have just a short period, perhaps a maximum of 10 days within which to submit the memorandum. I doubt if the senators will require too much time to decide. I imagine they should just have enough time to peruse the memorandum, and each one then grapples with his own conscience and arrives at a decision.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let me get our final words from Congressman Nery and Attorney Quicho. Congressman, dahil natapos na kayong mag-present, for all intents and purposes, what are your hopes?
Well, I just hope na the message we're able to deliver to the people, the evidence we're able to present dun sa impeachment trial, para sa amin convincing, no? At syempre, of course, in the end, sabi nga ni Dean Raul, no? Titingnan naman yan, conscience ang term ni Dean Raul, eh.
Conscience.
So, if we are able to at least deliver the message, sa amin, simple lang talaga ang mensahe namin doon, no? Yung may nagawa ang respondent na tingin namin hindi na siya karapat-dapat maging Chief Justice. Na, pag may tinatry siyang taong on graft and corruption, sasabihin ng tao, sino ka na mag-judge sa akin? 5 million lang hindi ko na-declare sa salin ko, eh. In the same manner, pag may TRO na ini-issue, parang sino ka na, na ikaw nga na gano'n, no? So para sa amin may gano'n na kaming na-establish, and we just hope that the Senate, of course, will, the impeachment court will appreciate that.
Attorney Rico, it will be the defense's turn to present evidence probably beginning next week. What can we expect and what do you expect?
Opo, alam niyo po sa ating mga kababayan, lumalapit na po yung pagkakataon na kami po sa depensa ay makakapagpaliwanag na. Kami po ay ngayon maaari na po maglabas ng aming ebidensya at tumawag po ng aming mga testigo para po magpapatotoo na lahat po ng mga aligasyon na nakasaad po doon sa verified complaint ay pawang kasinungalingan po at wala po itong katotohanan. Ngayon po, sa pagkakataong ito, ay mapapakita po namin na si Chief Justice Corona ay karapat dapat pa pong magpatuloy bilang po ng mahistrado ng Korte Suprema. At handa pa rin po siyang manilbihan, katulad po ng ginagawa niya sa mga nakaraang panahon na po sa ating mga taong bayan po.
Okay, very well said. That wraps up ANC Presents Chief Justice on Trial. We'd like to thank Congressman Eric Colmenares for joining us, Attorney Rico Kicho of the Defense, and of course, Dean Tony Lavinia and Dean Raul Pangalangan there in the studio. And thank you for joining us tonight, as always, every Tuesday night. This is ANC Presents Chief Justice on Trial.